Hello, boys and girls. So welcome to episode 14 of the potential players that Arsenal could be signing this summer. And again, we're going to go back into the centre of defence because, of course, that is an area that we need to strengthen. Now, the player I'm going to mention today, he comes from Sampdoria, and I'm sure you've heard his name a lot recently, and it's Joachim Andersen. Now, I know this deal is actually a double deal that Arsenal were trying to sort out with a guy by the name of Dennis Praet, who is a midfielder. And it comes as part of a package, but I'm going to focus on Andersen for today instead of trying to deal with both of them in one video. Of course, like I said, they play for Sampdoria, and we could well be going back to do business with them because last summer we took Lucas Torreira from them, and it seems that we do have a very good relationship with them. So what can I tell you about Andersen? He's Danish. He's a young lad, he's only 23 years old. He hasn't made an international debut yet. He has played for the Danish under 21s. 6'2", and he's very highly thought of. He's got a very high ceiling, like I said. He's 23 years old, and it's very evident that Arsenal are looking at these younger players now. He does not have a release clause, neither does Praet either, because you've got to remember this is part of a package. Arsenal have apparently already put a £43 million bid in, which was rejected, and Sampdoria are holding out for £49 million for the pair. Andersen's individual valuation, you're probably looking around about the £25 million mark, and that's not too bad. Started out his career predominantly at FC 20. Sampdoria signed him for only £1.4 million. So just like Lucas Torreira, they would make a tidy profit, that's for sure. 32 games in Serie A last season, had very good performances. And like I said, he's highly thought of, and he's going to be a loss to them. That's most definite. Some interesting news, which has recently come out in the last 24 to 48 hours or so, is that, of course, Sampdoria look like they're losing their manager to AC Milan because they've recently got rid of Gattuso. And of course, who's at AC Milan? Ivan Gazidis. Now, apparently, publications in Italy are stating that AC Milan want to bring in Andersen and Praet as a, a welcome package to their new manager, who is coming from Sampdoria. Now, they spoke to Andersen about this. He says he doesn't know what's actually going on with the manager and whether he's leaving. But if he does, it'll be, you know, a bit of a blow. Says how much that he's enjoyed playing for him and that he doesn't really know too much about his future and that AC Milan are a great club and he can't really say no more than that. So I suppose that's kind of the, you know, reply that you would get from a player. But of course, publications have looked at it and blown it up into a big thing saying that, you know, AC Milan could come along and scupper Arsenal's plans. And it looks very much like Ivan Gazidis could be trying to get one over us. And you wonder why I don't like the guy. One of the key factors that I always get into in these videos is injuries of a player, because that's very important where Arsenal are concerned, given some of the problems that we've had in the past. And Andersen's injury record is very, very good. His first injury was in 15-16, and that was just an illness, and he was out for 2 days. 16-17, he had a shoulder injury, kept him out for 32 days, and his most recent injury was April in 2019, and that was an unknown injury, and it kept him out for 32 days. So that's very good. Doesn't really have a history of injuries, and like I said, that's very key where Arsenal are concerned because of recent history. I'm gonna compare some stats now with a current Arsenal defense at the moment, just to give you a kind of indication and gauge as to what they're doing. Andersen is very much a ball playing center back. Very clear that's what Unai Emery wants. Someone that's comfortable on the ball, someone that can dribble the ball, pass the ball most notably, because that's where we've had problems with the likes of Mustafi and even Sokratis. Rob Holding is the ball-playing centre-back at Arsenal, and where he's been injured, and we don't know how he's recovering and how he's going to come back, this is what we need within the side. So, yeah, it's very evident you know, the comparisons and what each player does. We're going to look at the overall defensive side, and I'm going to compare him to Sokratis. Appearances, Sokratis was 25 and Andersen was 32. Minutes on the pitch, 2,199 for Sokratis, 2,880 for Andersen. Tackles, 1.7 from Sokratis and 1.3 from Andersen, so very strong there from Sokratis. Interceptions, 1 from Sokratis and 1.1 from Andersen, so very good from Andersen. And it's very clear that he's good at the interceptions, reading the game and then passing the ball out. Fouls, 1.5 from Sokratis. We know he likes a foul, Andersen, only the one. So very strong in that point there from Andersen. Offsides, 0.7 for Sokratis. This is reading with the offsides and everything else. And Andersen, 1, so very strong from him there as well. Clearances, 4.3 from Sokratis and 4.5 from Andersen, so very strong as well. Dribbles, 0.5, 0.4 for Andersen. Again, another strong point for him. Blocks, 0.7 for Sokratis. Likes to get his body in the way, so very good stats for him, whereas Anderson's 0.5. Overall ratings are Sokratis, 6.82 and Andersen, 6.84. So very, very good stats from Joachim Andersen. The actual passing, dribbling and everything else, we're going to compare the stats with Mustafi. Appearances, 31 for Mustafi, 32 for Andersen, like I said. Minutes, 2,617 for Mustafi, so slightly less than Andersen, of course. Key passes, 0.2 from Mustafi and 0.3 for Andersen, so better stats there for Andersen. Average passing, 56.9 for Mustafi and 63.4 for Andersen. Pass percentage, 81.9 from Mustafi, 88.8 for Andersen, so very, very strong. Through balls, 0.1 for Mustafi, and they haven't actually got a stat for Andersen in that. So overall, when you're looking at those kind of ratings and the passing and the completion and everything else, Andersen is a lot better. And I think that is very key for what Unai Emery wants and what he needs within the team. He's a young lad. He's only going to get better. Like I said, he's got a high ceiling. What could he bring to the team? I think he could bring a lot to the side, to be quite honest with you. I think when Arsenal fans are talking about the double signings of Andersen and Payet, it's Andersen that actually gets fans a little bit more excited. And it's him that we clearly need to strengthen in. Could he be one of two centre-backs? Is this the kind of name that gets you excited, or is it the kind of name that we're kind of, you know, the window we're shopping in? These are the kind of budgets that we're looking at. Let's not look too downbeat on it and think, oh, we're signing this player, I haven't really heard of him. Because like I said, look at the last player we bought from Sampdoria. A lot of people were sitting there at the time and thinking, who the hell's Lucas Torreira? I think within the World Cup and after a few months at Arsenal, you know full well who Lucas Torreira is now. So Andersen could be a very good addition to the squad. Would he be the only signing? Or could he actually be one of two signings in that central defensive area? As usual, let me know in the comment section what you think. Would you like to see Andersen at Arsenal? Would you like to see him just be a single signing? Or are you happy with the double signing of Payet as well? 49 million, what do you think about that price tag as an overall? Is that a good deal that Arsenal would be getting for both players? Is Andersen worth the 20, 25 million pound mark that they're quoting on his own? So yeah, if you're new around here, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you smash a like on this video. And like I said, leave your comments. Let me know what you think. There's going to be so much more content coming out. The Premier League fixtures are out in a couple of days. Very interesting to see who we face. So I'll be going through those fixtures in detail. There'll be some more of these videos. I'm going to do one on Payet as well. And hopefully I'm going to be doing a video soon of a new signing. Hopefully. We'll wait and see. So until then, I'll see you lot soon. I'm out of here.